At Tremco, we decided to put in a pilot plant or an insulating glass lab in order to provide better services to our customers. We can simulate the actual manufacture of insulating glass units in a pilot plant setting. Only clean and dry glass can be used to make insulating glass units. Anything else will cause early failures. This is achieved by putting it through a glass washer, which soaks and brushes the glass very thoroughly and dries it through the action of an air knife, which dries the glass as it exits the washer. Once that's done, we can then feed the anti-edge into the inside notching tool, and then we can be ready to apply it to the piece of glass that's on our application table. We apply the spacer using an inside notching tool, which has marks which allow us to establish the start and finish points and the corner cutting points in the process. You'll see that we transit along the edge of glass, which applies a given inset, typically 3/16 of an inch, sometimes 1/4 of an inch for that setup. Once we reach a corner, we make a cut. We do that 3 times, and then on the 4th time, we make a different cut which overlaps the start-finish point in the application. Topping or glass alignment is the process by which, after we've applied the anti-edge spacer, we take the applied light of glass, we place it against the pop-up stops, we take the second piece of glass, which is known as the top piece, we flip it so that the clean side is down, and we align it with the aligning blocks and place it on top of the applied piece of glass. Once we've done that, we press down to secure the adhesive. Now the unit is ready to be run through the compression press. The adhesive on the edges of anti-edge is pressure sensitive, and we need to compress it approximately 40 thousandths of an inch in order to fully wet out the adhesive. This is critically important because after we do this, we're going to be applying hot melt. If the adhesive is not properly secured, you can possibly get a defect known as blow-by, where the hot melt enters the unit. Hot melts are butyl products with very low moisture vapor transmission rates. The reason they're preferred in the industry is they provide a long life cycle for the unit. Hot melts, as their name suggests, are applied hot, typically around 350 degrees Fahrenheit. The temperature allows the hot melt to be gunned into the opening and flow so that you get a complete hermetic seal around the IG unit. Enerseal is an ideal hot melt to use on the anti-edge spacer because it has tremendous adhesion to glass, the spacer, and flows very well but maintains its viscosity so that it doesn't drip out of the opening during application. It provides structural strength and prevents moisture from entering the unit through its life cycle. After the hot melt application, there is a gas filling station where we insert argon gas into the cavity of the unit. Once gas filling is complete, we use the hot melt gun to apply a small patch of hot melt to the openings previously made. We then use the troweling pad to push those hot melt plugs into place and complete the seal. Once hot melt's complete and the unit has cooled sufficiently, it can be racked. A racking system for IG is required to support both lights of glass equally so that the unit does not displace during storage. Usually customers wait until a rack is full before taking the units over to the glazing operation, where the IG units can be glazed into a sash or a frame.